Good morning, everybody. I'm gonna give it a minute or so, let everybody jump on here for our terrarium class. Hope everybody enjoyed all that sunshine that we've been having the last few days. Makes us kinda eager for spring, especially around here. We're all getting ready for the spring season. So I'm sure you all have been anxious too. So during any point in this terrarium class, I have my moderator, Kylie, here. She's gonna be letting me know if anybody has any questions. So during the Facebook Live, if you have any questions, please ask. If you think of something after we're done, I continually go on for a day or two to answer any additional questions anybody has. So looks like we have quite a few people jumping on, so I'm going to get started. A little introduction. My name is Erin. I'm the perennial manager and director of education here at the Bloomingdale Platt Hill Nursery, and I'm going to be doing a terrarium how-to today. The one thing about terrariums actually is that you can really be creative, and you know, you don't have to have the specific, you know, perfect bowl or an enclosed terrarium. Use whatever you want to use for your terrarium. So, you know, if you have something laying around like this, you know, cute little kind of, what are these, like port glasses? You can do this if you just want to put one plant in it. We have these really cute little hanging terrarium types, which I'm going to do a quick little how-to with these guys. If you have a cute wine glass or just some jars hanging around, or if you go to thrift stores, you can find some really cool glass. We do usually have terrariums available. We did order a bunch. Unfortunately, with COVID, all of our shipping has been back ordered, and we're still waiting, and everything's kind of been delayed. So just kind of see what you have around the house to kind of have some fun with it. So I'm gonna put this a little so you guys can see what I'm doing a little bit better. There we go.
Yeah, talk a little bit louder.
Oh sure, I will talk louder. Sorry, it gets a little noisy in the greenhouse here, so I apologize about that. So the first thing with the terrarium, the first thing I like to use is actually horticulture charcoal. And so what horticulture charcoal does is it kind of absorbs any of that extra water that you have. Sometimes when you have an enclosed planter that doesn't have any drainage, the water can kind of build up and it will tend to smell kind of musty and old. And the horticultural charcoal works really good in kind of absorbing that smell and that mustiness. So you need very little. So I'm just going to pour a tiny, that's going to be your first thing you put in the bottom of your terrarium. I'm just going to pour a really thin layer. You can see it's just a really thin layer. You don't need a lot of it. And then we're going to put in our soil or our potting mix. So we have a custom blend that we use here, but you know, you wanna use any kind of potting mix that's really nice and loose. We do have an Espoma organic potting mix that is really nice and loose. You can use a Miracle-Gro type potting mix. If you do, make sure you don't use it with any kind of, if you're going to do like a succulent type terrarium, don't use that with succulents. Miracle-Gro tends to be very thick and dense and will tend to hold the water a little bit more, and then you can get root rot. So if you are going to use a Miracle-Gro, make sure you use plants that can tolerate a little bit of moisture, like a fern. You can use ferns in terrariums, are really good because they like a lot of moisture. Any type of moss is really good. So you want to just be careful of what type of soil potting mix that you use. So I started out, I just put a little bit, maybe like an inch, half inch of potting mix in here. And my plants that I picked out a while ago are actually quite tall now. So I want them kind of small. So what I'm going to do is actually just kind of prune them myself a little bit so I can kind of make them a little smaller. They will grow And as they grow in your terrarium, you can actually keep pruning them. You can use little scissors. I use my fingers. But anytime some of your plants, they'll tend to get real tall. And then I'm using, so my for my tall one, I'm using this arrowhead plant. And then I'm going to put a fern in because they do like that moisture and it gives it kind of a nice fine texture. For some color, I'm going to be using this one. I think it's an Aurelia. It's got kind of a nice kind of maroony color. And then for my low growing one, I've got a baby tears right here. And these are kind of a real nice low growing that'll kind of spread out in your terrarium. So what I'm going to do is take the first one here and just kind of loosen up the mix a little bit. So as you can see, this one's pretty tall in the terrarium. You don't necessarily have to use a tall one. Actually, to tell you the truth, I think this one's too tall. So I'm gonna use my fern. And that's kind of the fun part too, is you can kind of play around with the plants that you like, can kind of move them around a bit. So there we go, that's better. So I'm gonna use, got my fern in here. So it's kind of what I would consider my tall. And then I'm going to take my Aurelia, kind of loosen up the soil mix of that. And I'm just, and we will fill these in with some potting mix when we're done. And then I've got my baby tears. Now my baby tears has, again, since I put it aside, has kind of grown a little too much for what I want in my terrarium. So I'm just going to kind of trim it a little bit. Loosen up the soil and kind of squish that down in there. So I'll kind of bring this up for you guys to see a little bit. So I've got my three plants. I like odd numbers, whatever, you know, whenever they teach us in design, it's always odd numbers. So I am doing three plants today. And then what I'm going to do is kind of little bit here, fill it in with a little bit more mix around here to cover that root ball. And then just kind of tap it down. So I do have these fun little terrarium tools that I like to use that kind of help me kind of put a little bit of soil around here, kind of rake the soil down a little bit. And then I have a little brush that kind of helps get some of the dirt off the top of the plants here like this. So these are fun. I use them all the time when I'm doing succulent planters, terrariums, anything that's really small. I love to use these guys. So then what I like to do is I always like to have kind of a nice top for my terrarium. You can use different colored sands. You can use different colored rocks. Just something to kind of give it a little color. My favorite is bluestone. We have a blue chip bluestone here. It's just a small little kind of a grayish bluish rock. It's my favorite because I always feel like it kind of brings out the color of the plants. Now this is an open terrarium. So there are closed terrariums, and the closed terrariums, if you do use those, every once in a while you do need to open the top up and kind of let it breathe. You do want to keep it closed to kind of build that condensation in there. But do make sure if you are doing a closed terrarium that you are doing plants, using plants that can tolerate that. The ferns are great. The Aurelias are great. This little baby tears is okay. Some of the more succulent baby tears don't particularly like that, don't particularly like the closed. There are certain plants like succulents that don't like droplets on them. They will rot the actual leaves. So make sure you're using the right plants for the right type of container that you're using. So as you can see, I like to put my plants together and kind of let them grow. You don't have to do it this way. You can put one plant way over here, one over here. That's just my personal preference, how I like to use them. So I've got a nice covering of blue chip here. So I'll kind of move this up. You guys can kind of see how pretty that blue chip is. And then I like to do some fun stuff. We've got a cute little fairy garden mushroom. If you've got any crystals or stones, those are always fun to put in these too. Again, the fun thing about terrariums is you can make it your own. So I'll put this little guy here. I've got some really pretty blue chip stone that we have that I kind of just will put around here. You know, if you have a cool piece of driftwood or something like that, use something like that too. So just a quick, easy way to make a cute little terrarium. And again, this is what we call our open terrarium. So in regards to watering the terrarium, if you have an open one, you will need to water a bit more than a closed terrarium, because obviously with a closed terrarium, it's kind of providing its own water. So as you can see here, the soil mix that I have is pretty light colored. So at this point, I know it's time to water, and I forgot to bring a little watering can with me. So hold on, let me grab one real quick. And so what I'm going to do is, actually I'm going to put a little more blue chip in here. And so what I want to do is water this until it looks like not all of the soil, but most of it is a nice dark color. Now, as your plants get bigger and bigger, they're going to use water much faster. Once we come into spring and it starts getting more light outside, the plants are going to start growing faster. I do want to say too, most of the terrarium plants like a nice bright room. You never want to put it right in front of a window, because if you get the reflection from the glass, it will actually burn the plants. So you do want to have a nice bright room, but again, you don't need to have it right next to a window. Most houseplants actually don't like to be in direct sun. They're not used to that. So let's see here. So after I watered it, it's a little bit darker here. I know there's kind of a glare in the greenhouse here. So the soil's a little bit darker. And so I'm just going to kind of let that dry out and get nice and light again. And once it gets nice and light, then it's time to water. Anybody have any questions at all? It's pretty easy. The terrariums are pretty easy. We have some nice little terrarium plants here. They're these little 2-inch plants. We have quite a selection, so you can kind of find some fun ones to do. And then what I'm going to do is show this one is our little kind of hanging terrarium. So this you can do a couple things with. You can take a cute little air plant. We have lots of different air plants here, and literally just put it like this. Or actually what you can do to make it really cute is take a little bit of kind of some pretty colored rock or pretty colored sand and just set your little air plant like that and hang it, and you have a cute little hanging air plant there. Or if you want, you can definitely do the terrarium. So you want to make sure to put a tiny little bit of the charcoal, and it's really messy. And then just take a little bit of potting mix. And then I took one of these ferns also, a real low growing fern. I'm actually going to trim it a little bit more. So for this one, you're probably going to need to take most of the soil off of it, which is fine. The plant's not going to hurt the plant at all.
Cheryl asked, is it okay, or is watering a closed terrarium not needed?
Cheryl was asking if watering a closed terrarium is not needed. It's definitely not needed much. You do want to keep an eye on it, especially if you have plants in there that will tend to dry out a little bit more. Something like a fern typically needs a little bit more water. And again, it really depends on how much condensation your closed terrarium has. So if you see quite a bit of condensation in the closed terrarium, you should be okay. And if everything looks like it's moist consistently, you should be fine. If you look like you're not getting as much condensation as you should, you may want to occasionally, you know, every couple weeks or so, check it. Kind of tap your, you know, kind of feel the soil And if it does feel dryish, or you notice your plants are kind of wilting or getting a little crispy on the ends, you definitely want to water. And again, with a closed terrarium, you do occasionally want to open it up and kind of let it air out. It can kind of build some algae up on the sides of them, and a little bit of mold. So you do want to, I'd say like once every few weeks or so with a closed terrarium, you want to open it up and let it kind of dry out a little bit. So I kind of took all the soil off. I squished my little plant a little bit, which again, they're fine. They don't mind that. And I'm just kind of filling it up with some soil here. Actually, it might be easier with my little tool. Then I'm just kind of tapping it down, using a little bit of the bluestone. And again, this type of thing, you don't want to use too big of a plant that has too much root system, because you can see it's a very, very shallow container. And I'm just going to put a little bit of my bluestone around here, kind of give it a little decoration.
Lynette asks, how do you handle a closed terrarium? Will the plants stay smaller? Do you have any specific plant recommendations?
Lynette was asking if the plants will stay smaller in a closed terrarium. Not necessarily. Depending on how much light they get, if they're in a nice bright room, they will tend to grow fairly well. For closed terrariums, again, I always recommend like a fern, a moss, those type of plants. They do really well. I wouldn't use anything that requires kind of dry, which would be like a succulent, that type of thing, but they will. If they get enough light, most plants will do a decent amount of growing. I've seen really large closed terrariums where the plants have actually gotten quite big, and you can leave them that way. You can trim them. Again, they don't mind being, plucked and pruned and stuff like that. You can see what I did with the ones I had, and these guys will be fine. Probably in about a month, in my regular terrarium, these guys will start getting bigger, so we'll have to start kind of pruning them to keep them on the smaller side. But yeah, you'll just, again, most of it is how much light the plants are getting. Again, ferns don't typically like direct light. They kind of like some filtered light. They can actually tolerate a little bit of low light too. So if you don't have an area that has a lot of light, the ferns and the mosses especially, because mosses typically will grow in shadier areas. So the mosses do really well too. And I thought I saw on one of our order sheets we are getting some mosses in. So that'll be kind of fun. You can kind of use those. And mosses are nice because if they come too big in a container, you can literally cut them. I've cut them with scissors. I've ripped them apart with my hands. They're pretty easy to kind of manipulate and make fitting to a size that you want. So here's kind of our little tiny hanging terrarium. Super cute. Just kind of an easy thing to do if you just want to try out one plant. You're not particularly ready to try one with a few plants.
Joel asks, is it okay if you put a layer of stone at the bottom instead of charcoal?
You can do, who is asking that?
Joel.
Joel, you can do that, Joel. The rock, though, will not absorb that musty odor as much as the charcoal, but it will still kind of absorb a bit of that. So you can use rock. You don't, if you're doing a small terrarium, you obviously don't want to buy a huge bag of a horticultural charcoal. We use it a lot here, so I opened a bag up. But yeah, the rock is fine. It's, again, you may have to occasionally kind of take everything out, put some new fresh rock in there at the bottom, because again, it will kind of collect that water and get kind of musty, stale smell. And then also too, if you're doing that, you can kind of, trim your plants if you want to put some new plants in. It is okay to occasionally take apart the whole thing and redo it. You can also, if the root systems on the plants have gotten too big, you can also do some root pruning, which will keep them small. And basically, that's just cutting the root system, which totally fine. That's actually how they do bonsai, is by root pruning. That's how they keep them small. So pruning those roots will kind of keep those plants smaller. If you notice you have a particular plant that tends to grow a lot faster, you can definitely do the root pruning.
Joan asks, how long can you expect a closed terrarium to last? Could it go on for years?
Joan was asking how long a closed terrarium could last. Years. Houseplants are kind of infinite, I feel like. People come in, they've got 30, 40, 50-year-old houseplants. So basically, terrarium plants are just a very immature, smaller version of the houseplant. So they could go on for a very long time if you're watering it properly, if you're letting it air out occasionally, or also giving it the condensation it needs. They can definitely go on for quite a while. Eventually, if you let the plants get bigger and bigger and you're not root pruning them, eventually they will stop growing, only because you have very little soil in there, and eventually you will have the root system completely take over all the soil. But you will notice that the plant isn't doing so good. It stopped growing. Maybe it's got some yellowing leaves on it, and then you'll know it's time to kind of take the plant out, root prune it, prune the actual plant, put in some fresh potting mix, and you should be able to keep it going indefinitely.
Jose asks, are succulents okay for an open terrarium?
Yeah, succulents are okay for an open terrarium. You just want to make sure that you're not doing any kind of misting on them. Succulents don't like droplets of water sitting in them and the leaves, because it will actually rot if they get stuck in the crevices. But you can definitely do a succulent terrarium. Yeah, as long as it's not closed, it definitely, in something like this, you could easily do a succulent terrarium for sure. If you do, I would, because there is no drainage, I would use a cactus and succulent mix, which has quite a bit of drainage. Make sure to put some of that charcoal and quite a bit of rock, at least a half an inch of rock, to kind of catch any of that water, and really watch your watering. You really want to make sure you completely dry out all of that soil before you water if you are doing a succulent one, mostly because you don't have any drainage on there, and succulents do like a lot of drainage. So as long as you're careful with your watering and you don't overwater, you will notice with succulents, if you are overwatering, the leaves will start rotting and they'll kind of get squishy and fall off really easily. So that would tell you it's really time to back off on the watering.
Chablis asks, can you use aquarium charcoal?
Can you use aquarium charcoal? I think you can. I think it's, as far as I know, it's the same basis of what it is. It's just kind of trapping that musty smell. So yeah, we have horticulture charcoal here because we're a nursery, but I think aquarium charcoal is fine to use. It's kind of the same thing. It's used in the same way.
And then Karen asks, how often do they need to be fertilized?
Karen's asking how often they need to be fertilized. I would say maybe once a month for sure. You really want to, because they're such small plants, they really don't need a lot of fertilizer. So you really want to use just a tiny bit of fertilizer. During the winter, you really want to back off on the fertilizing. They aren't using a lot of energy during the winter, so they can tend to burn a bit if you're using too much fertilizer. During spring and summer, when we're having longer days and it's lighter outside for longer, and we're getting more sunlight, obviously, you can definitely fertilize, I'd say once a month. You don't want to fertilize too much, though, because that will push those plants to grow really fast, and then you'll be constantly cutting them back or having to repot them or reuse different plants. So the potting mix usually has fertilizer in it. And because they're such small plants, they will take a while to use that fertilizer in the potting mix. So if you do fertilize, do it very sparsely, just a little bit occasionally, and you should be good.
Coach asks, can you build different levels, build up part of the bowl to be higher?
Yes, we had a question. Can you build up part of the bowl to be higher? Definitely. Yeah, I've never done that before, but I have seen terrariums where they have been built up, and you can definitely do that. I would probably put ones at the bottom ones that tend to like more water, like a fern or a moss, only because with a multi-level, the water's gonna tend to kind of drain down a bit. So your top one would be one that could tolerate a bit less water, and then your lower level ones are gonna be the ones that will tolerate a bit more water. But yeah, it could easily be done. Again, that's the fun thing about terrariums. You can kind of do whatever you want. Experiment, play around with different containers, different types of plants, different colored sands and rocks. It's really kind of a fun way to be creative with your plants.
Ellen asks, are there any good plants that flower to use?
Are there any good plants to flower or that are flowering to use? I'm kind of looking at what we have for flowering. The only real small one we have that flowers is the calancho and the calendiva. They're actually quite big. Let me grab one real quick. I'll show you. So this is the calancho. As you can see, it's kind of big. As far as real small, and usually our terrarium plants that I see never flower. We usually just get foliage plants. You can, if you were to do something like this, like a calancho or calendiva, I would consider it a succulent. So you definitely want to treat it that way in different type of potting mix, different watering schedule. But yeah, I'm just kind of looking around the greenhouse here, and everything flowering is actually quite big. But if you have a really large container and you want to put some flowering stuff in there, by all means. Now, flowering is going to require a touch more fertilizer. Flowering plants do use quite a bit more energy, so you may want to fertilize those a little bit. I'm trying to think of what else we have. We have some really tiny cyclamen here. Some little 2-inch, but yeah, usually the smaller ones we get flowering are more of a succulent type. So, all right, I think that's it on the questions. I'm going to kind of wrap it up here. Again, if you think of something throughout the day, please post your question. I will be going online onto Facebook onto this video and kind of checking to see if anybody has any more questions. As you can see, it's really nice and beautiful in here. We got a lot of house plants. We got a lot of blooming stuff. We just got some shamrocks in. So if you're looking to kind of brighten up your home, we've got lots of fun stuff. Or if you're looking to kind of get out of this gray, dull day, come on in and hang out. Next Sunday at 9 a.m., I'm going to be doing a seed starting Facebook Live. So please join me for that. I know it's a real big issue, real big topic right now. A lot of people are looking to start seeds on their own. So I'm going to be doing a really kind of in-depth how to start seeds and how to start growing your own fruits and veggies and herbs from scratch. So please join me next Sunday at 9 a.m. on Facebook Live. Hope everybody has a great day.
There's a
And
few more
oh, couple
questions.
more questions. All right.
So Karen and Dennis ask, could you use small orchids?
Karen and Dennis were asking, could you use small orchids? Yeah, I think you could actually, because orchids like a lot of humidity. So yeah, you could definitely use orchids. I would be careful of the type of mix. Make sure you use an orchid mix and maybe like some sphagnum moss for your soil mix. But yeah, you could definitely do. I would do the horticultural charcoal too with those guys because they tend to kind of hold a little bit more water. The moss does. So I would use the charcoal because it can get a little smelly. But yeah, definitely use a miniature orchid. That would be really pretty.
And then Ellen asks, do we make them for arrangements here?
Do we make terrariums? Yes. Yeah. I haven't lately, but we normally do have a few out. I'm going to put the couple I made out for sale, and I'm probably going to make a few more in the next week or so. Or if you want to come in, if you have a particular container and you want to pick out the plants, we'll pot it up for you, no problem. So yeah, definitely.
And then Cheryl asks, can I use plants meant to be in a fish tank and underwater and enclosed aquarium?
Yeah, Cheryl was asking if you can use aquarium plants in an enclosed container. Yes, that would be perfect. Type pond plants, aquarium plants for enclosed, they would love it because they like all that water and all that moisture. So yeah, that would be a really good thing to look into.
Do you have evergreen trees? And is it okay to plant with the cicadas coming this year?
Somebody asked about evergreens and cicadas. That would be our nursery manager, Scott. I don't, we always have nursery, or we always have evergreens for sale. We have a huge variety of evergreens. I have just recently heard about the cicadas this year, but I haven't heard anything about not planting them. But you would definitely want to talk to our nursery department, and anybody in the nursery department would know for sure. All right, I think we're good. I hope everybody has a great day, and hopefully we've got some more sunny days coming ahead, and we will see you next week for our seed starting class.